I got a question from Mela Konea asking, how do you use photographic textures for line features in ArcGIS Pro? The goal is a creative map that looks like it's made out of threads, and I think that is very cool. Here's how I would do it. Now here I am at unsplash.com and I've searched for yarn. Oh, by the way, if you've not looked at unsplash.com, that's a great source of free images, beautiful photography that you can use. And I think this has some promise. Now you might not realize it, but I can zoom way in and cut a relatively straight section of yarn out of this image, which means I'm gonna have to download the original really big resolution. Let's do that. And while I'm here, I'll also pick up some fabric. And in Photoshop, I'm gonna break out the shears and just slice off a little bit of this yarn. You can use whatever image editing tool you like. And I'm using the erase tool to get rid of the stuff on either side of the line, and I've isolated just a relatively straight stretch of thread. ArcGIS Pro's picture stroke requires a vertically oriented image, so the line has to go up and down. Also notice that where the thread goes off screen and the top and bottom of the image are pretty much similar to each other. That way you have continuity when this image is repeated across your line. You don't get any mismatched jaggies, which means that maybe you'll have to rotate your image before you do this. And then I just crop it and save it as a PNG with a transparent background. Here we are in ArcGIS Pro, and I've got a simplified line work of coastlines from Project Line Work. But at first I need a good base. So I'm gonna open Living Atlas and search for Global Background, my favorite layer in the world. I'll add Global Background. This is just a big rectangle that covers the whole world. Now let's give it a texture. Instead of a solid fill, I'll choose Picture Fill and Picture Quality, and I'll just navigate to the fabric file that I downloaded from Unsplash and give it a nice generous size. And now we have a good fabric base to work from. Now we can turn our attention to the stroke, and I'll choose Picture Stroke. And again, choose Picture Quality and just navigate to this yarn graphic that we made. Give it a decent size so we can see it. And look at this, look at their preview. We can see what we're gonna get. Looks like you've just coiled up some yarn in the shape of Australia, and that's glorious. But did you know you could tint anything? Anything that's white can be given a different color, and it'll tint it to say dark blue in this case, like a nice coast. But what if we get crazy and duplicate this? And for this other stroke, I'll give it an offset and make it look like a little ripply waterline with a light blue. Now we've got some little draped yarn coastal water ripples. And while we're at it, feeling crazy, let's get extra crazy and make a little tan coastline out of yarn, because why not? We're making a map out of yarn. If we're gonna have fun, let's really have fun. And the cool thing about digital virtual texture maps is that as you pan and zoom, it's happy to redraw. And there's like unlimited ways you can get your texture on. In this case, I got a sand background and then photoshopped a stone path for a nice stony border appearance. Why not? Oh, also, I've zipped up a bunch of images that I've used as line picture strokes in the past, and you can find them in the linky placey. There's practically no limit to the sorts of material maps that you can make. Have fun.
Merry Christmas!